In times like these, oh Lord, we need an anchor. In times like these, oh Lord, we need a Savior. And we will intentionally make sure, oh God, that our anchor, who is Jesus, grabs hold of the solid rock. Father, we depend upon you, we rely on you, and we need you. We ask, oh God, that for the rest of our time that you would come and occupy the space in our heart and in our mind. We give you back every talent, every ability that you've granted us, that we might honor and please you in this time. And Father, I pray, even as the words come out of my mouth, that those who belong to you will hear your voice. That your glory cloud will fill the room in such a way that I'm no longer seen. I'm no longer heard, but your people hear your voice, feel your presence, sense your power. We ask, oh God, as we stand in faith, that all of these things are. Use me according to your will, and we give you the glory for it. In the name of Jesus Christ, do we ask it, believe it, and receive it, counting it done. Amen. 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 Out of Ephesians 3, we have read verses 14 through 21. I would like to read verse 14 again. Ephesians 3:14 says, "For this reason I kneel before the Father, from whom his whole family in heaven and on earth derives its name." And if I were to give you a thought to hang your hat on this morning, it would be, we're family. We're family. Also, would you skip down to the last part of 17, and it reads, "And I pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power together with all the saints." So this is a family relationship with benefits. Sister Allison and the choir used to sing a song, "We're family bound by love that time can't take away." We're something in a perfect kind of way. Anyway, I love the song, and it kept ringing through my mind as I was reading these scriptures. But we're family. As each of us grow older, I'm going to ask you the question, who are you looking like? Who are you sounding like? Who you acting like? Is it your mom? Or your dad? That's really okay. Seeing that all of your DNA came from your mom and your dad. I will tell you that my hair is thinning in the same places my dad's did. And I found myself saying the very things my mother said to me. Even though I vowed I'd never say that to a child. I'd never treat my children that way. Sometimes Ollie may come out of me and I go, "Woo." And don't tell her I called her Ollie Mae. Does any of this sound familiar to your situation? As we grow in grace and in the knowledge of Christ, we are also to take on the likeness of our Heavenly Father. We are called sons, even though some of us are females. We are called sons of God. And that is because of the unique and special relationship that we have with Him. I will tell you, in biblical times, girls and ladies and daughters did not inherit. Hello. But we have such a unique relationship with God that He says we are the inheritors of whatever He has sent forth. So therefore, we are sons. Don't get offended in the word when it says that, you know, my brothers or my sons. He means daughters too. Amen. Our special relationship with God grants us a new DNA, and that's a divine, never-ending acceptance. Because we are not turned away if we dishonor the family name. How many of you said nasty things in Jesus' name? Yeah, even if you thought it, you may as well have said it. We are forgiven if we make mistakes, and there's always another chance waiting in the wing if we need it. But our response to this relationship is to become like Christ. Now, some of us don't think that we need to be doing all that. That's too much. I'm not feeling it. But when, and I just appreciate the Sunday school lessons for the last two Sundays and how it talked about the lineage and the genealogy and how even though David was the king, Jesus was the son of David. Even though David didn't have nothing to do with his birth, but God fixed it and ordered it down through the 42 generations so that Christ, to fulfill the prophecy, would be the forever king. Solomon thought he was the forever king. And we understood that because of his idolatry and marrying, that he wasn't able to fulfill that. But even though he wasn't perfect, God did not turn him away and say, well, you messed up the line of David and I can't use it no more. He just continued to use every person that came in line until perfection happened. And that's what I love about God. Being a part of his family, because I slip or I make a mistake or I don't do it quite right or think it quite right, he doesn't pluck me up out of the line and throw me on the trash heap. Because of the new DNA, the divine, never-ending acceptance, he picks me up, he brushes my knees, he'll fix my skirt and say, daughter or son, are you ready to start all over? I love that about God. And even though that I am here in Toledo without natural family, he gave me such a wonderful family that I can see every day. Thank you, Jesus. You know, they're close enough to touch. I don't have to take that 15 hours to Connecticut, but I can call up Wanda and I can speak to Brother Deloney and my big brother over here, Robert. I can just talk to them and they can tell me and support me or correct me, whatever needs to happen. And that I am grateful. But in Galatians 3 and I think it's 6. We are called also inheritors. It says, you are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. For all of you who were baptized into Christ have clothed yourself with Christ Jesus. If you being in Christ, then you are all Abraham's seeds and heirs according to the promise. I love how God just covers me. He let me in, even though I had no legal right to get in and to get in line. He covered me. I think it's 3 and 6. No, it must be 3 and 26. 26. That's an ugly 2. You are all sons of God through faith in Christ Jesus. And what I like about it, if you go down to the next verse, 28, he says, there's neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female. You are all one in Christ. He doesn't look at me and say, oh, well, you're Buster's daughter. You can't come in. You know, you don't have the right bloodlines. He said, that's okay, because the blood that Jesus shed on Calvary is enough to cover you. And when I look at you covered in the blood of Christ, you look like Jesus. You talk like Jesus. You walk like Jesus. So welcome into the family. I love that about God. It doesn't matter that I was raised in the projects of Bridgeport, Connecticut. It didn't matter that, you know, there were 10 of us around a table and one chicken wasn't quite enough. You had to get in where you fit in, okay? But he always made the door open. He said, so whosoever will, let them. But there's a response to all of this. We have to take on the likeness of our Heavenly Father. Some of us look like our moms and walk like our dads and talk like grandma and big mom and them. But if you are in this family, you are required to take on the attributes of your big brother Christ. So if you're not walking like Jesus and talking like Jesus, come on. We gonna let you catch up, okay? We're not gonna throw you out. Because if you wanna be the inheritors of this inheritance, then you have to take on the likeness. All of these connections allow us to possess the traits of Jesus and ultimately our Father. So don't grow faint, but persevere. Yeah. Don't cave in so quickly when it gets difficult. Know who has your back. Yeah. Your daddy God. Yeah. You know, because my older brother is with the Lord. And my other brothers are too busy. They couldn't have my back. But if I call my big brother, he was there. On the one. Yeah. Who's messing with you? Right. What they say? Just point them out. And I stand there. It was them over there. I loved how he just vroom, vroom, just walked up. Anyway, I love the fact that somebody has my back. We're family. This is why Jesus made an open door into the family of God. He made us connected so that we'll be strong. He said, let the weak say. Because there's some things about saying the stuff you're not. We can speak it up. We can speak up a headache, a stomach ache, the flu. But he said, I brought you into the family so you will be strong. You don't have to do it all by yourself. Because you're connected on the left and you're connected on the right. You're connected in the back and you're connected in the front. I made you family so you'll be strong and never weak. He brought you into Christ. He brought you into the family so Christ can dwell in your heart. Because you can't do it depending on you. If I could do it depending on me, Jesus never would have had to die. But even though my mind says, my spirit is willing, honey, this flesh get in the way all the time. You too tired? You too old? You too fat? Whatever it tells you. I didn't get no amens, but that's okay. We were bought into the family so that Christ could dwell in our hearts. He brought us in the family so we'd be rooted and grounded in love. Because God is love. Love is the motivator for everything we do or should be. Not a love for a big name. Not a love for a reputation in the community. But because I love God, I want God to be seen. I want to do it right because it is right. Not that nobody won't find out that I've done it wrong, but I want to represent my daddy. I want my daddy to be known and well known, renowned around me. So that's why we were invited into family, so that we'd be rooted and grounded in love. Because love will make you do right. Well, there's a song that says, love will make you do wrong and whatever. And if loving you is right, I don't want to be wrong. Oh, whatever. But you know I'm not that familiar. But love will make you do it right because it is right. That's the only point I want to make. We're family. We were called into family, so at his appearing, we may know the breadth, the length, the depth, the height of God's love for us. We can appreciate it, but we will never know the depth, the height, the length, and the breadth of God's love until he comes back to get us. Until he begins to show us what he forgave us of. Until he demonstrates his mercy and his kindness in spite of our proclivities and inclinations. He said, you're my brother, you're my sister, we are the sons of God. And because you adopted me and let me adopt you, then all of this is forgiven. All of this is wiped clean. All of this is in the past. And all you have is a future. I will tell you, if you're not a part of the family of God, you are missing a great opportunity. And this is why. Because nobody knows the day, the moment, or the hour where he'll come back. All I can tell you is that he's coming. And if you don't, if you're not in it, you can't win it. You can't get ready. You have to be ready at his coming, at his appearance, when he get here. Because there ain't no time to get ready after that. So you need to know if you're in the family. You need to know if you have the connections. And not, well, I'll do it when I'm 21 or I'll do it when I'm 22. That's not even promised. I'll live for the Lord next year. I need to have my fun. Who said living was promised to you next year, next month, in the next moment? All I'm saying is, if you're not a part of the family of God, you are missing. Because there's a breadth, a width, and a length, and a height, and a depth of the love of God that we will only know when the family gets together. I am so glad to be in the family of Christ. Yes. I'm not saying I have it all and there's millions of dollars in the bank. I don't live in, that's not Bunker Hill. What is that? No, right there. I don't live in Westmoreland in those big stone mansions or mini mansions, whatever you want to call them. But I'm telling you, I have a peace that I can't understand. I have joy in the midst of mess. I can get up even when I'm tired and say, Lord, I thank you and I praise you and I bless you. When there's not enough money and too much month, I can say, God is still the source of everything I need of. Why? Because he's my daddy and I'm his son. And as a son, I am in line for the inheritance of not only love, but mercy and grace and peace and joy. I have it because it's mine to have. I don't want you to be in the family and miss all the good stuff. You just want to go to heaven. I need my stuff here. I need it now so I can make it to glory. Amen. So that's what being a part of the family is. Don't just become a part of the family so I can go to heaven. If you're in the family, that'll happen. But you need some joy, some peace, some covering, some forgiveness, some power right now to get through the end of the day. Especially after they stole that hour from me last night. I don't know who got it, but I want it back. We're family. And I'm grateful. And all of our relationships are not smooth and wonderful. But I want it to be a blessing so God can bless me. Thank you for being my brothers and my sisters. And I pray that I am a brother. I am a sister to all of you. Ooh, it's that hour. Bless God.